सिंह एंड अगेन। तो आज मैं क्लास शुरू करने से पहले आपको दो चीजें जरूर बताना चाहता हूँ। फर्स्ट चीज तो है, थोड़ी खुशी की बात है मेरे लिए, क्योंकि मैंने एक ही हफ्ते में टोटली 100 सब्सक्रिप्शन मैंने आज पार कर लिया है। सो इसके लिए धन्यवाद एंड कीप सपोर्टिंग मी। देन सेकेंड चीज, आप जैसे कि जानते हो आई शुड टॉक ओनली इन इंग्लिश, बट मुझे थोड़े पर्सनली ऐसे कमेंट आए स्पेशली फ्रॉम GNM और BSc नर्सेस कि वो बोलते हैं वो रूरल बैकग्राउंड से, तो उनका थोड़ा लैंग्वेज प्रॉब्लम है रिलेटेड टू इंग्लिश। तो वो बोलते हैं कि इंग्लिश तो मत करो, बट जिधर जिधर पॉसिबल है उधर थोड़ा हिंदी भी बात करो। सो आज से मैं थोड़ा थोड़ा हिंदी भी बात करने वाला हूँ। बीच बीच जिधर जिधर मुझे लगता है कि ये थोड़ा सिक्वेंस टफ है और ये जो भी कॉन्सेप्ट है थोड़ा टफ है, मैं जरूर उसमें हिंदी मिस करना चाहता हूँ। ये आइडिया इसलिए देना चाहता हूँ क्योंकि मेरे लास्ट वीडियो में आपने देखा होगा, मैंने उधर मेंशन किया है क्लियर कॉन्सेप्ट इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड। मेरा इंटेंशन है कि मैं उसको नहीं बोलूं कि जिसको ऑलरेडी पता है, मेरा इंटेंशन ये है कि जिसको पता नहीं है उसको मैं वो कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर करूं। तो यही एक गोल के साथ मैं आज आगे बढ़ रहा हूं और मैं मेरा नेक्स्ट क्लास शुरू करने जा रहा हूं। सो थैंक यू, कीप सपोर्टिंग एंड कीप कमेंटिंग फॉर मोर सजेशंस एंड डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द कंजेनाइटल हार्ट डिजीज सीरीज। As earlier we have seen related to the asymptomatic condition, under that increased pulmonary blood flow I have completed. Next, moving towards the obstruction to blood flow from ventricle. In this particular condition, whenever you see hemodynamics, at the last there will be obstruction to blood flow from ventricle. Means wherever there are ventricle, it may be a pulmonary opening or it may be a aortic opening. Whenever there is a blood flow towards these walls, automatically it is obstructed. Because of that obstruction, usually blood will not flow to a particular path where it's supposed to flow. So starting with the new condition, that is coarctation of aorta. So before description, just I wanted to let you know the colors, why I am using the particular color. Means मैं आपको बोलना चाहता हूँ कि मैं क्यों रेड और ब्लू कलर यूज करना चाहता हूँ। बिकॉज रेड कलर wherever I use, that indicates oxygenated blood, and wherever I use blue color, that indicates deoxygenated blood. So coming to the structure, as you know, this is superior vena cava, this is inferior vena cava, this is descending aorta, this is pulmonary artery, this is particularly left pulmonary artery, right pulmonary artery, right atrium, left atrium, which are called as upper chambers. Then right ventricle, left ventricle, which is called as pumping chambers also. Then the specialty, the special feature in this is your BSC arteries, that is your brachiocephalic artery, your subclavian artery and carotid artery. The mnemonic is very easy to remember, that is BSC. You are already a BSc nursing student. If you are studying BSc, you are a BSc nursing student. So it is very easy to remember these three. Again, B is brachiocephalic, S is subclavian, C is carotid artery. So the importance is here. If you see, I have like highlighted with a green color. Especially this particular part is highlighted because see the importance is here. Coarctation of aorta. As you know, coarctation is nothing but narrowing, and aorta is a biggest artery. This is narrowing. This particular condition is narrowing of aorta. See, this is localized narrowing just after the patent ductus arteriosus, where you will have increased pressure proximal to defect. मतलब एक localized aorta का narrowing है जिधर आपका ऊपर के शरीर को बहुत ज्यादा प्रेशर जाएगा, ब्लड प्रेशर जाएगा, और whereas to lower part of the body the pressure will be very less or decreased. मतलब आपके नीचे के शरीर को ब्लड बहुत कम जाएगा. क्यों कम जाएगा? सी, एक बार इधर से ब्लड आ गया तो इधर नैरोइंग है, तो इधर नैरोइंग है तो ब्लड ज्यादा मुंह हो नहीं पाएगा, इसलिए ऊपर के पार्ट को ब्लड बहुत ज्यादा जाता है और नीचे के पार्ट को बहुत कम जाता है. मींस द ब्लड फ्लो विल इंक्रीज टू द अपर साइड ऑफ द बॉडी और अपर एक्सट्रीमिटी, एंड ब्लड फ्लो इज वेरी लेस to the lower part of the body. So this is about the coarctation of aorta. Let's start with the hemodynamics. एक बच्चे ने मुझे कमेंट में पूछा था कि हीमोडायनामिक्स क्या है. सी, हर एक डिसीज कंडीशन को पैथोफिजियोलॉजी रहता है, मतलब फिजियोलॉजी कैसे अल्टर होता है. बट इधर हीमोडायनामिक्स है, क्योंकि हीमोडायनामिक्स पर्टिकुलरली कंजेनिटल हार्ट डिसीजेस में ब्लड फ्लो चेंज हो जाता है, वही उसका पैथोफिजियोलॉजी है. तो इंस्टेड ऑफ यूजिंग टर्म पैथोफिजियोलॉजी, वी आर यूजिंग अ टर्म हीमोडायनामिक्स. हीमो इज रिलेटेड टू द ब्लड, डायनामिक्स इज रिलेटेड टू चेंज इन द ब्लड फ्लो पैटर्न. सो हीमोडायनामिक्स इज नथिंग बट व्हाट इज नॉर्मल ब्लड पैटर्न एंड व्हाट इज अबनॉर्मल ब्लड पैटर्न. सो वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हाट इज हीमोडायनामिक्स ऑफ द कोऑर्डिनेशन ऑफ एओर्टा. एज यू नो, द ब्लड ऑलवेज फ्लो फ्रॉम सुपीरियर नाकावा, इंफीरियर नाकावा. सी, आई एम यूजिंग ब्लू कलर बिकॉज इट इज डीऑक्सीजनेटेड. वंस इट कम्स टू द राइट एट्रियम, देन फ्रॉम राइट एट्रियम ब्लड विल गो टू द राइट वेंट्रिकल. फ्रॉम राइट वेंट्रिकल इट विल गो टू द पल्मरी ओपनिंग और पल्मरी आर्टरी. फ्रॉम पल्मरी आर्टरी इट विल फ्लो टू द राइट पल्मरी आर्टरी, लेफ्ट पल्मरी आर्टरी. आफ्टर दैट वंस द लंग रिसीव द ब्लड, ऑटोमेटिकली द डीऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड विल कन्वर्टेड इन टू द ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड एंड ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड विल फ्लो फ्रॉम ऑल फोर पल्मरी वेन टूवर्ड्स द लेफ्ट atrium. Once it comes to the left atrium, blood will go to the left ventricle. Left ventricle, from left ventricle it will go to the aortic opening. From aorta it will flow towards the ascending aorta. But when it reaches the ascending aorta, there is a narrowing here. This is your coarctation of aorta. So where exactly blood do not move as fluently as in the normal hemodynamics. So blood will stay here. So because of that, there is increased pressure in upper extremity, and because of that, the lower extremity or the lower part of the aorta will not get adequate supply. So this particular part will be having decreased blood supply or decreased pressure. There will be decreased pressure to lower extremity. So because of that, the upper part of the body is having high blood pressure and the lower part of the body will have low blood pressure. So this is related to the pathophysiology. And one more thing you can see here, why this comes under obstruction to ventricle is that because of this coarctation, because of that, the pressure will revert back. Again, there will be pressure towards the right ventricle. So this is the reason it will come under obstruction to blood flow from the ventricle. Next, moving towards the flow chart of hemodynamics, the blood from superior vena cava plus inferior vena cava, it will come to the right atrium. From right atrium, deoxygenated blood will flow to the right ventricle as usual through tricuspid wall. From that right ventricle, blood will go to the pulmonary artery. From pulmonary artery, that to right plus left pulmonary artery. From that, it will go to the lungs as usual. From lungs, the oxygenated blood will come to the left atrium. From left atrium, it will go to the left ventricle through bicuspid or mitral wall. Then from left ventricle, blood will go to aorta as usual, that to ascending aorta. From ascending aorta, there should be a mechanism that it should go to the descending aorta. But as there is a localized narrowing, there is less amount of blood flow to the descending aorta. Because of that, it increases pressure in ascending aorta or the proximal aorta. Proximal aorta have increased pressure and the distal aorta has decreased pressure. This is the reason why, which puts back the pressure or which puts the राइट एंट्री कर इन टू द ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन वेर देर इज नो प्रॉपर सप्लाई और देर इज नो प्रॉपर हीमोडायनामिक्स. सो दिस इज वाई दिस पर्टिकुलर condition will come under obstruction to blood flow from the ventricle. Clinical features. The first clinical feature. Here you can see two cardinal signs. The first clinical feature is that there is increased pressure in upper extremity with bounding pulse in upper arm. See, this is very common because once there is a narrowing proximal to the defect, the proximal part will get high pressure or it get pressurized. Because of that, if you see the from this BSC arteries, the blood flow will increase to the upper extremity as we discussed earlier. Because of that, whenever you feel a pulse, especially when you feel the brachial pulse or carotid pulse, it is bounding, very blasting because of the high pressure. The second thing is that decreased blood pressure or weak femoral pulse with low temperature in lower extremity. As you see, more amount of blood will go to the upper extremity. It's very common that the lower part of the heart or the parts which are present below the heart will get less amount of blood flow. Because of that less blood flow, the resistance decreases. Because of that, you can see if you feel femoral pulse or if you take the blood pressure from the lower extremity, it is very low. And if you see, if you assess blood, because TPR are the one which are vital signs, temperature is low at the lower side, you see blood pressure, that is also low. So these are two cardinal signs you can see only in coarctation of aorta, and which is very typical to understand during physical examination. Structure of aorta. As you see, the increased upper extremity or increased pressure in upper extremity start again increasing if you do not treat it at the first stage itself. If narrowing is too much of the defect is too narrow, then the blood flow within the or the pressure start increasing. Because of that, in some chances the aorta may rupture. And fourth one is aortic aneurysm. Aortic aneurysm. Aneurysm is nothing but abnormal dilatation of artery. Because of increased pressure, you can see a dilated or very largely dilated aorta. And because of that, sometimes a baby may get fainting. Then if it is not treated in early condition, congestive heart failure, and lastly there is a chances of death also. So these are the clinical features which are present in coarctation of aorta. Next, coming to the diagnostic evaluation, as you have seen in all the conditions, history collection is common. Here also we will assess the family history, whether somebody is suffering from congenital heart diseases. We will assess whether baby is exposed to like radiation or whether there is any problem in the family history. So these are all things will be assessed in the history collection. Once we assess that, the second most important thing is physical examination. Under physical examination, we should remember always, whenever there is high blood pressure at the upper side of the body and a low blood pressure at the lower side of the body, or when there is cool extremities at the lower part of the body and normal or high temperature in upper part of the body, it always 90% it suggests coarctation of aorta. As you already know the hemodynamics, so it depends upon the hemodynamics. Once you assess or once you auscultate the baby, then automatically you will come to know this thing. So third one is related to the X-ray. As you know, X-ray is the one which initially gives a basic idea where exactly the defect is. After that, you can do ECG. ECG is to monitor electrical activity or action potential within the heart. Definitely, there will be changes in the ECG parameters. Next one is Holter monitoring. Holter monitoring is usually to assess electrical activities of the heart for 24 hours. If at all देर आर इंक्रीज प्रेशर एट द अपर पार्ट ऑफ द एओर्टा एंड डिक्रीज प्रेशर एट द डिसेंडिंग एओर्टा, इट मे गिव सजेशन और इट मे सजेस्ट कोआप्टेशन ऑफ एओर्टा. एंड लास्ट वन इज कार्डियक एमआरआई. कार्डियक एमआरआई गिव्स एग्जैक्ट लोकेशन वेयर द कोआप्टेशन इज प्रेजेंट विद इन द एओर्टा एंड इट गिव्स एग्जैक्ट idea or slices of slides. So how much is like narrowed, what is the percentage of narrowing, what is the percentage of blockage. So all the like inferences will be given by this cardiac MRI. So these are the diagnostic evaluation related to the coarctation of aorta. To include the management, under management it is divided into two. The first one is non-surgical management. Under non-surgical management, first to know the defect or visualize the defect, angiography is done. As you know, angio is related to the blood vessel and graphy is related to the visualization. The visualization of that particular aorta is done to know what are the, like what is the percentage of narrowing. And second one, if there is a narrowing, the angioplasty is done. Angioplasty, here particularly a cardiac catheter is inserted within the aorta, and once the it is a through balloon angioplasty, it can be automatically dilated and the narrowing will be decreased by that. The narrowing will be automatically decreased by that. Surgical management, under surgical management, the first surgical management is resection of end to end anastomosis. For example, here what they will do, if this is your narrowing, if this is your narrowing, they will remove that particular narrowing or narrowed part. Means the part is resected where there is narrowing. Now the end to end, this particular part they will bring here and they will suture it. So the normal blood flow will be maintained. So this is resection of end to end anastomosis. Second one is subclavian flap aortoplasty. Subclavian, as you know, the subclavian is one of the artery who supplied blood to the left arm. Flap is a part of subclavian is removed and it is used to repair the aorta. So for example, if this is, say for example, this is the your aorta and here there is a narrowing. Here what they will do? They will do end to end anastomosis here also, and they will attach a part, they will attach a part or a flap of subclavian artery. इसमें क्या किया जाता है, subclavian एक artery है, जैसे कि आप देख सकते हैं इधर कि वो बीच का artery है, उधर का उसका थोड़ा टुकड़ा जो लेके जिधर भी narrowing रहता है, जिधर narrowing है उधर वो लगा देते हैं ताकि blood flow जो भी हो normally maintain हो. Patch aortoplasty. Last we have seen, we have used a subclavian flap, but in this case particularly a patch, a synthetic material is used to particularly replace this particular portion. For example, say this is a particular synthetic material. For example, say the narrowing is very big. In this particular condition, to increase the length or to increase the length of aorta or to match this particular aorta, a synthetic material is particularly used. That is called as a patch aortoplasty. Next is a post-operative management. Post-operative management, particularly in coarctation of aorta, is very necessary because there are some of the medications which a neonate or a baby need to take for a longer duration or whenever it is necessary. The first one among that is sodium nitroprusside. Sodium nitroprusside is given to immediately reduce the blood pressure. See, say for example, whenever there is like aortic rupture or whenever there is a abnormal aortic aneurysm, when there is a dilation is increasing more and more, then immediately to reduce that dilation, the sodium nitroprusside is given. And one more important thing, as you know already there is a decreased blood flow. Here we are also decreasing again blood flow. So it should be given whenever there is a need and whenever there is severity is increasing. Second one is Ismolol. This is a cardioselective beta blocker where it is particularly used when there is increased heartbeat. So to decrease that, टू डिक्रीज द हार्ट रेट इट इज पर्टिकुलरली यूज एंड इट डिक्रीज द अबनॉर्मल हार्ट रिदम ऑल्सो वेन एवर देर इज अबनॉर्मल हार्ट रिदम दैट ऑल्सो इट डिक्रीजेस. थर्ड वन इज मिलरिनोन. मिलरिनोन इज अ वैसोडायरेक्टर व्हिच इज रेयरली गिवन पोस्ट ऑपरेटिवली जस्ट टू इंक्रीज द डायरेक्शन टुवर्ड्स द लोअर पार्ट. वेन एवर लोअर पार्ट इज अफेक्टेड मोर एट अ पर्टिकुलर टाइम ओनली दिस इज गिवन. रिमेंबर सोडियम नाइट्रोक्लोराइड इस्मिलोल एंड मिलरिनोन these are given to avoid the complication or to avoid the severity. Whenever there is increased upper extremity abnormality, sodium nitroprusside and ismolol are given. Whenever there is severity increase at the lower part of the body, then milrinone is given. So this is all about the coarctation of aorta. धन्यवाद दोस्तों मेरा ये coarctation of aorta का वीडियो देखने के लिए. और मैं हफ्तों में दो बार मेरे वीडियो डालता हूँ तो जरूर मेरे वीडियो देखिए और जितना पॉसिबल है आपके फ्रेंड्स को आपके रिलेटिव को आपके स्टूडेंट को जरूर शेयर कीजिए और बोलिए उनको कि मेरा चैनल डेफिनेटली वो सब्सक्राइब करें.